May I have your attention, please? Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Please turn off your cell phones and fasten your seatbelts. A first-class Christmas is about to begin.
Annoying Christmas music and jazz. Never. that.
Peace on earth. Right here. Right now.
I don't understand.
We are not sitting out there with all the losers flying in economy class. Just look at them all. It's gotten so crowded out there now. It looks like a bus station in a third world country.
When I was a kid, I had this ant farm, right? What you got here is a giant ant farm. You got the big glass window and all the little creatures scurrying about on the other side.
Young man, let me tell you. Flying economy, well, it's like riding in a roach hotel with wings. But we're not sitting out there with all those coach roaches. Instead, you and I can thank God because we are in
the first class, preferred platinum, luxury lounge. Yes. To peace on earth.
And goodwill to these two men. Thank you.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Compliments of the management.
Is she going to do that every single time?
Okay. You know, that's what I hate about Christmas. You got all these sappy songs about silver bells and city sidewalks and peace on earth. I mean, honestly, what a load of...
Oh, where's Kenta? I'm dreaming of a Christmas just like the ones I used to know.
Please, just leave the tray. And then just leave? Where was I? Oh yes, I was about to deliver my toast.
Hey, me too! I'm delivering my toast to you two gentlemen. Get it? My toast? Isn't that hilarious?
You are great, gentlemen. Two screwdrivers for Black and Decker.
have been delayed until further notice. Once again, Los Angeles International Airport is closed to all air traffic until further notice. We apologize for this untimely inconvenience and have directed airport security to take all necessary steps to make you as comfortable as possible. We would also like to take this opportunity to wish you all a very Merry Christmas.
You have got to be kidding me!
This is totally unacceptable. I must be in New York for the merger negotiations. This is inexcusably poor service for the amount of money that I have paid. Well, just get Gordon if he's not going right now.
Who's he?
He only owns this airline. He owns you for that matter. And he owed me a big favor.
No! 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 No, you don't understand. No, you don't understand. The company president invited me for the holidays. I'm expected to be in New York. No, this is my gift for a partnership! I can't blow this! No, I need to be there. I need to be there, okay? And I need to speak with someone with authority, okay? No, I need to speak to someone with authority right now, okay? That was fast. Thank you for coming so quickly.
Excuse me, sir.
I said thank you for coming so quickly.
And I said, excuse me, sir, because you're in the way. Could you please step aside and do my job?
Yeah, of course. Anything to help in an emergency?
All right, folks, step this way. Come on. There's plenty of room in here. Oh, that's a boot too.
What do you think you're doing? Put that back! Who are all these people? You can't just barge in here with just anybody.
Have a seat, sir. Have a seat, sir. Calm yourself. Listen carefully. The Congress is extremely overcrowded. As director of TSA for this terminal, I'm very these people in the lounge as a public safety president.
is important announcement. Your attention, please. This is a reminder to keep all carry-on luggage and personal items with you at all times. If you observe any unattended bags, contact airport security immediately. Your TSA staff thanks you for your cooperation and wishes you all a safe journey and Merry Christmas.
Hey, miss, is there any food left in the kitchen?
No, we haven't eaten since 6:30, and that was over 5 hours ago.
I'm sorry, everybody. All we have left is bottled water. I'll try calling again, but don't get your hopes up.
Commentary on my age.
I'm so sorry. She actually
got the next one. What's it called? It's Frosty the Snow. I'm kidding. It's called the Red of Jesus.
Really?
Yeah. And, what's your rebel Jesus rebelling against?
I don't know.
Hatred, injustice, greed, death. Let's look at this.
The world is filled with laughter. Music of the season. The merchant's windows all are white with the faces of the children. Families hurrying to their homes as the sky darkens and freezes. They'll be gathering there with their own, celebrating all God's graces. And the birth of a rebel. Say he is the Prince of Peace. They call him Lord and Savior. And all their prayers are for their own wants and needs. That he'll bless all their endeavors. And they fill themselves up with their greed and gold. Their selfish pride increases. It's the farthest thing from how that rebel walked. For the peace that really freed us. They hardly know their real Jesus. We guard our world with locks and guns. We guard our fine possessions. And once a year when Christmas comes, we give to our relations. Perhaps we give a little to the down and out. That generosity thing should seize us. But if any one of us would do a little more to share the problems and the pain of the suffering and the poor, we'd get the same as that rebel Jesus. Pardon me if I have seen take the tone of judgment. I truly have no wish to come between this day and your enjoyment. In a world of trouble and of earthly toil, we search for anything that could free us. So I bid you comfort and I wish you cheer. I'm a heathen and a pagan here. Now on the side of that rebel Jesus.
Convinced that that had actually happened. And one by one, history tells us they were willing to die for that conviction. I mean, sure, some people stand up and die for things they think are true. But these men and women, they were in a unique position, to know whether or not it was true. I mean, they were there. And I don't know too many people willing to die for a lie, you know, or for a fairy tale. I'm beginning to believe there's good reason to think maybe this Jesus somehow survived death. And I don't even know what that means yet. But if that happened, if Jesus survived the grave, man, maybe I need to reconsider what side I'm on. And maybe you guys do too. Maybe you said it yourself over there. Only the strong survive.
Ready, set, go. Wait. Action.
In that same country, there were shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night.
And lo, the angel...
No, not like that. With feelings.
And lo, the angel of the Lord appeared, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid.
And the angel said, "Fear not, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people.
Today, in the city of David, is born to you a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
And this will be a sign unto you. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger."
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the
highest."
We have heard this all before. Peace on earth, goodwill to men. Frankly, I'm getting sick and tired of it. Story time's over, boys and girls. You too, Tiny Tim. And God bless us, everyone.
Sandy. Really? She's just a kid.
I'm really sorry about that. You know, he's really tired of, well, everything right now. Hey. Are you okay?
He left off the ending.
What?
He did it wrong. He left off the ending.
Did it? Sounded right to me. Tell you what, why don't you do it over again so I can hear it the right way?
And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill to men. With whom he is well pleased." That's the part he left off. With whom he is well pleased.
Really, are you sure about that? I mean, what's that supposed to mean, with whom he is well pleased?
It means what it says. If God is pleased with you, he gives you peace, and he'll take care of you.
I can take care of myself, and I've got plenty of peace.
Really? Are you sure about that, sir?
Okay, Liz. I'm sorry, Mr. Decker.
No worries. Really. But just sounds so ridiculous.
What exactly sounds ridiculous, Mr. Decker?
All right. Okay. How can you really know if you please God? Seriously, logically, bottom line, unless you're perfect, you can't know for sure.
You're exactly right, Mr. Devlin.
But nobody is perfect. Okay, so then how can you, or me, or anyone else for that matter, ever expect to please God, let alone find peace?
nobody's perfect, right? That's why Jesus comes. That's why he dies for us. He takes the blame for our sin, and we get the credit for his perfect life. He loves us, so he made it simple. Simple and free. Compliments of the management.
Backwards, Mr. Decker. It's
seems like it's set in the right direction. Liz, I wanna thank you for an unforgettable evening. I hope you and your grandpa have a very merry Christmas.
Thank you. You should keep it. Compliments of me, because you really need it. What? Well, he does. We all need the Bible, right? I hope you make it home soon. Do you have a long way to go?
It looks like I've got quite a ways to go. But I've made a good start.
Your attention, please. This is your airport announcer. A first-class Christmas is now officially over. You are all invited to stay for a time of fellowship and yummy snacks. Don't forget to gather your personal items as you leave tonight. We want to take this opportunity to wish you all a very Merry Christmas.